game, one champion, one lasting memory. And only one coach will ascend the ladder and cut down the final piece of the net. Mr. Vitale and I will be watching to see who climbs to the top of the men's basketball mountain after tonight's game between the Xavier Musketeers and the UNLV Runnin' Rebels.
Both teams need to forget about the wild crowd here and play basketball.
Dick, if you were coaching either one of these teams, what would your points of emphasis be?
First off, they must send multiple players in for offensive rebounds. I think that if they can crash the boards, good things will happen for them. Secondly, look to advance the ball up the court with the hit-ahead pass in order to put pressure on the defense. Lastly, they should really look to create some turnovers, press, trap, do whatever you have to do in order to disrupt the offense.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, here we go.
And we tip off here in the first.
Now the dribble gives it up. Here comes a pick.
Hey, ball speeds are such an important part of the game these days. Guys are so creative when it comes to using that ball screen.
The small forward with the ball. Check out this highlight, Nick. Obviously, potential candidate for the 18-year-old.
Wow, that's a great play, Brad. Definitely worthy of being highlight material.
Man might be in a little bit of trouble here, Nick. Great composure to pass it out of the trap. Long down court pass.
Hey, dodge from there.
The small forward with the ball. Turns it over.
Another turnover created by great D, Brad.
This team, they love to pressure the full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Nestler. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
The skip pass is picked off. The Runnin' Rebels have really made some progress in recent time.
Hey, they sure have, Brad, but I guarantee you that they want to continue on this trend.
For two, the lane. Trap there.
Up and inside.
Takes the jumper. A lot of people can't hit that shot anymore. Like that 10-12 foot shot.
Yeah, the medium range shot is an extension.
They're going to move it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. The Runnin' Rebels have found a player who cannot seem to miss it.
Brad, he's on fire.
Dick, you got to be prepared when you go up against this team. They love to pressure the full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Nestler. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
Gave it up.
Great defensive play. Anticipating well. If you're an anticipator, you got a chance to do well. A lot of guys are reactors. If you're a reactor, you're one step behind the action. He almost found himself in some trouble there, Brad.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Coach has been quite animated all time.
Great effort defensively. He says, thou shalt not enter thy lane, baby. Get it out of here. I'm the landlord. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a new offensive set. It's even more important
to have some offensive instruction by the coach. Passes it out of the trap.
Great composure to pass it despite the trap, man.
Goes right through the trap.
Right around the trap.
Tries for two. Dick, they really need to get something going in a hurry here.
Yeah, call time out and get your boys into the game, Brad.
The Runnin' Rebels look like they want to use their defense to speed up this game.
You know, pressuring in the full court is a great tactic if you have the horses. Otherwise, it doesn't make much sense to play full court defense, Brad.
inside. He gets the rejection. The layup. Number five continues to impress me. He could very well be the best junior in the nation.
Gosh, is he ever? I haven't come across one person who doesn't feel as though this young man is one of the best in college basketball.
He bangs it in for another score.
And the hits just keep coming on, baby.
The running Rebels are looking to force a Temple by extending their defense.
You know, forcing your opponent to play the full court is a great idea if you have the athleticism to play that style, Brad. Otherwise, you may not be very successful pressuring the full court.
Number 31 gets the ball. Outside jumper. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Nick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. The Running Rebels are up-tempo team, Nick. What are the components that make up a good up-tempo team?
Up-tempo teams are all about speed and athleticism. Players who can play up-tempo and maintain a high skill level are unique and highly sought after.